Hello, I thought I'd do a video showing you what I use as a laptop bag. This isn't a laptop bag, this is an attaché case or briefcase made by the Greek company Diplomat. This is an old one. I got this one secondhand because there was some issues with it. There was no key. I made my own key, I'll show you that. So there was no key, there was stuff stuck to it. There's all kinds of scrapes and broken bits of zips and stuff. So I did it all up and I keep it for my laptop. But I thought I'd show you this. So we've got a combination here and a key there. And on the sides are the buttons to open the case. So we pull them outwards and that opens the case. So there's areas in the back that people can put papers and things. I've put some padding in here. There's my laptop in its padded little case, which walking around with that isn't as nice as having it in a nice case like this. I mean, the thing is, not having a key, bit of a downfall. So after picking it, I discerned that it's a wafer lock that only has one wafer. So that has no peaks and valleys, no ups and downs, it's just straight. So all you have to do is just, if I can zoom in here, all you have to do is insert the bit of plastic. You might be able to see here. That's the one wafer in the front. So you insert the bit of plastic and turn. So what that does is the same thing as if the code was incorrect. So even though the correct code is on here, 808, the button will not disengage the mechanism here. Even with the correct code, with the wrong code, it doesn't make any difference. You need to deal with the key first. So it's kind of like a double lock system. So put the plastic in, give it a twist. Now you can't just stick something in the front bit and just twist like that. You actually do have to press in the wafer. So it is decent, but this is not a super high security case. I just wanted to show you this because, I mean, I think it kind of looks cool. That's why I wanted to get it. And the thing is, it's more handy having an attaché case like this, which is hard. It's not super hard. I mean, I'm pressing the back, and it does bulge. So it's not super secure. But compared to most briefcases, attaché cases, it's kind of in the same ballpark, basically. But if I wanted to take something else to work, I could take my laptop out of here, leave that at home, and put tools and gadgets and whatever I need in here, and just take this. And then I'm good to go. And because I made it a key, I thought I was going to have to do more work on this. Thought I was going to have to jiggle it open, get it to like a half position, and kind of use just educated guessing based off of feeling the wafers to try and make a key that might fit it. But when I realized it was just one wafer, that made it so trivial. So I really like this. I think it just looks really cool. A bit retro-y, but it looks nice, I think. And as a bonus thing that I'll show you, since I already have it anyway in my collection, I have here a proper professional Alfa-Proj handcuff here, which is specially designed to be able to connect to cases or sometimes immovable objects, like in an interrogation type of situation. So this is made in the Czech Republic. So what you do is you thread this around the handle, then you open the handcuff and kind of feed it around on itself. And you can only feed it through while it's in the open position, because while it's in the closed position, it won't go anymore. It won't come off. So then we just tighten that up, and then you whack that on your wrist, and you just carry it around. So there's the little, it's not totally science fiction kind of fiction thing. I believe that this kind of thing is actually used in certain rare important situations, but I thought I'd just throw that in there just so that you can see that attached to a case. So there you go. If you found this interesting or useful, please like and subscribe, and I will see you on whatever the next video happens to be about. Thank you.